I'm Nicole Kulisek, and I'm a pediatric gastroenterologist, now working in Pfizer Specialty Care, where our focus is tackling overlooked, misunderstood, and serious diseases. Finding solutions must start with an informed understanding of the challenges, and someone who is at the forefront of both research into and application of advanced treatments for Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis is our special guest today. Dr. Jessica Allegretti is the medical director of the Crohn's and Colitis Center at Brigham and Women's Hospital, where she built and leads the clinical trials program. She also founded the hospital's fecal microbiota transplantation program and continues to serve as the program's director. Thank you, Dr. Allegretti.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you for having me here to discuss my absolute favorite topics.
So I know that while studying the pathology of inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD, you've also become familiar with the nuances of the patient experience. So tell us, in terms of what you have seen in the women you encounter in your practice, can you share some examples of how living with IBD can affect a woman's health beyond the physical aspects?
Yeah, absolutely. What I hear often is that it's been really difficult getting to the diagnosis, right? You know, which tests have been performed or haven't been performed, what they've been offered and what they haven't, can be really stressful. You know, and there's then again uncertainty around finding trusted sources of information. Often these patients don't know where to go to educate themselves with reputable resources. And, you know, all of this leads then to stress, right? More stress about not knowing what's going on with you or how to manage this chronic condition. And again, we know that the brain and the gut are connected. And the more stressed you are, the less likely you are going to be able to get into remission. So really acknowledging all of that upfront, especially when I'm meeting a patient for the first time, to really help build that therapeutic relationship, I think can be really empowering.
So what are some subtle symptoms or signs of IBD that women or even a primary care provider might overlook?
Particularly in Crohn's disease, the symptoms can be really vague. Patients can have weight loss, pain, anorexia, just this general sense of not feeling well. And so often those symptoms can be dismissed as either anxiety or IBS most commonly. And often what I'm told by my female patients is they've just been told to take fiber for years and years before coming to a proper diagnosis. When symptoms have often been dismissed or patients are told they're anxious and that's why they feel that way, or they just have IBS and that's really been dismissed, again, leading to this delayed diagnosis, patients are then left to get sicker and sicker. And this often, again, leads to ongoing mistrust with the healthcare provider and the profession, generally speaking, because patients, especially female patients, feel like they're not being heard. And so again, I think really listening to our patients, see what, you know, what have they been told previously, understand where they're coming from, and really working to build that therapeutic relationship, I think really goes a long way in getting that patient well and getting them on an appropriate treatment plan.